All right, Federal Reserve Chair Janet Yellen has spoken in what could be her final congressional testimony. Let's bring in Danielle DiMartino Booth, author of Fed Up, an insider's take on why the Federal Reserve is bad for America. All right, Danielle, we know that the Fed is on track for one more rate hike this year. Inflation has softened. We've heard that story. But
I want to get
right to the balance sheet, because the Fed, Janet Yellen, has introduced a new phrase in our terminology.
And it's multisyllabic.
Yes.
Wow.
She said the committee currently anticipates reducing the quantity of reserve balances to a level that is appreciably below recent levels, but larger than before the financial crisis. So what is...
Yeah, that's a big word for a central banker. Appreciably. It means like aggressively.
But is that $2 trillion, $3 trillion? We're at $4.5 trillion now.
So I'm not going to get technical on you, but the reverse repo facility that they have is capped at $2 trillion. So that is the amount of liquidity that they can inject into the market in times of emergencies. They will not shrink the balance sheet below that cap. And so that's why you hear the $2 trillion, $2.5 trillion figure bandied about.
Because I've seen a lot of analysts' research saying $3 trillion is the natural level that we're going to get to.
I mean, look, it's...
Whatever it is.
It's more money for the Fed to play with. It's more money for the Fed to remain an active investor in these markets. And frankly, my money today is with Jamie Dimon, not Janet Yellen. I think that the markets celebrate it today, the fact that Jamie Dimon has come out basically against quantitative tightening, which is... The Fed won't call it quantitative tightening, but it is the exact opposite of quantitative easing. So that's what it is. And Jamie Dimon, world's biggest bank, he's come out against it. So I think that's what the markets were cheering today.
Well, and when you were here a couple months ago, you said that you didn't even think the Fed would start this unwinding process.
I don't think they get there. I think right now that the markets are saying, try me.
Even with all this commentary?
Even with all this commentary. I don't think the markets believe the Fed. I just don't. And if they're seeing evidence that inflation is slowing, if they're seeing refinancing activity down 60% year over year, if they're seeing car sales down for the past 6 months, if they're seeing these data, then they know very well that the economy is slowing. So if it's slowing enough to justify them pulling back on rate hikes, then it's going to be slow enough for them to justify not reducing the balance sheet.
And Yellen said the balance sheet process would start this year, barring that the economy still holds up. So
you
she left she herself
an out. She used a disclaimer? Oh my gosh. Yes, of course.
Well, and she also said that the balance sheet is not an active tool for monetary policy. We've heard this before, but come on. I mean, quantitative easing
it is the flows that matter. Depending on whether you're talking about treasuries or mortgage-backed securities, the Fed is a very active player in these markets. 25 to 40% net issuance every single month. The Fed is actively in these markets purchasing just to keep the balance sheet at a steady state.
Right.
It continues to be a form of easing.
Do you think Yellen gets replaced? As I said earlier, this could be her last congressional testimony.
She said that this could be her last congressional testimony. Mm. So she acknowledged that. I don't think that this particular administration would allow a leak of this magnitude, as it's referenced to Gary Cohn, to float out there. Mm. And for the story headline to say the job is his for the taking, if there wasn't a lot of credence to it. And I think the street's also cheering the potential for him to replace Yellen.
Do you think he'd be a good choice?
I think he would be a much more rational choice. He certainly understands the banking system. He looks through a lot of the statistics that stop pure academics, flat. He's called out the unemployment rate for being smoke and mirrors in the past, and he understands the financial markets.
As has President Trump. So
indeed.
There you go. All right, Danielle DiMartino Booth, thank you for coming back with us.
Thank you.